Yo, it's me, DDP, and welcome to the Real DDP blog. And today it is Wrasslin Wednesdays. We have finally finished with the Savage Feud, the 1997 Feud of the Year. And now we're going to go all the way back to the insemination of Diamond Dallas Page. Like, how did I ever even get hooked into wrestling? How did I ever come up with the Diamond Dallas Page deal? You got the inside story right now. Now, if you're on YouTube or you subscribe to my YouTubes, well, you need to subscribe to DARRELDDP.com because you just won't get me talking on this YouTube. You'll get that the next day after I put this up, and then you'll get this video I'm about to talk about, and then the next video. It'll all be in one. So that's why you want to subscribe to TheRealDDP.com. Video blogs. Okay, so here's how it starts. I'm working at this club, I actually own a piece of it, called Norma Jean's Dance Club. It is the hottest spot from Sarasota, Florida to Cuba. I mean, we were running it. I mean, I was Diamond Dallas Page back then. It was a trip. So the bottom line is end of the night, you know, they're closing down the bar, and I'm at my buddy Smokey's bar, and there's a Cyndi Lauper video up there. My buddy DJ Johnny M is playing Cyndi Lauper at the end, trying to mix videos. And I see Albano, Captain Lou Albano, Cyndi Lauper, Piper was in that video. Nikita Volkoff was in that video. And I'm watching that. I'm going, damn. I go, rock and wrestling, man. I should have been a part of that. And Smokey goes, what? And I just walked away. I went in the back office. And you know, we're counting money, and we're drinking and partying. You know, it's the end of the night. So Smokey comes in, he goes, Paige J, now, why, what do you mean you and wrestling? You see, everybody called me Paige J because my dad was Paige 1, and as a little kid, I didn't really like being called Paige 2. So what my dad did, he knew I was a big Dallas Cowboys fan, he would say, hey, Dallas, your Cowboys are playing. So it sort of became a little nickname that we had. Instead of him calling me Page 2. Little thing there, I guess, not wanting to be number 2. As life grew up, me and my dad only knew about the name Dallas. So when I tried professional wrestling as an actual wrestler, actually before this, so I don't have, maybe I'll try and find a picture. I don't think I have any. I do have a video. I do have a card, though, from 1978 when I actually tried to become a professional wrestler, and it didn't work out for me. I had, like, 3 matches. I was horrific, horrible. I'll actually put that card up there. I think I have it back over here. Let me see. Where is it? I don't want to waste this valuable video time right now. I don't know. I'll find it. It's somewhere back there. And so I'll put that card up. So I tried it in 1978. It didn't work out. So here we are. We're back in, in the bar in the back room area. You'll see it in a minute in the video. And Smokey goes, Paige J. He goes, what do you mean rock and wrestling? I said, well, you know, I tried it when I was a kid. He goes, you tried wrestling? What was your name? Now, at the time, growing up as a kid, I was a huge Handsome Jimmy Valiant fan. So, as a tribute to Handsome, I called myself Handsome Dallas Page. And Smokey's like, whoa, you can forget about that gimmick. And everybody started laughing. So we're sitting around and counting money and drinking. And, you know, we all had guns back then. It wasn't like we were gangsters. We carried them and we shot them in the back wall. We had this big hole in the wall. It was a cement wall. And we shot guns. We had a little target practice and stuff. It was crazy. But, you know, we were kids. We were in our 20s. And Smokey was busting my chops, and I said, what about Diamond Dallas Page? What if it was DDP? I could see Peter fans chanting. They chant DDT. Why wouldn't they chant DDP? And, you know, now drink. Woo, yeah, great idea. Shot. We're drinking Goldschlager back then. For any of you guys from the 80s, you know what I'm talking about with the gold and the peppermint schnapps. Brutal. So then it goes from that to it actually goes to, me going, let's see, Diamond Dallas Page, DDP. Well, Jimmy Hart's got the Hart Foundation. Why don't I have the Diamond Exchange? Whoa, more drinks, shots, bang, bang. So now, you know, then I'm thinking, you know, a lot of guys, they have a valet here and there. I didn't think any of them were any of that hot. I mean, Elizabeth was good looking, but girl next door good looking. They weren't like stripper vanny, stripper vampy nightclub hot. And that was my world. So I thought, you know, what if I had a whole crew of different girls and I called them the Diamond Dolls? And Smokey was like, oh, that'll be a stretch. Everybody started laughing and shot, shot, drink, drink, bang, bang. And I just started writing all this down. Remember in some of my other videos, I've talked to you about ink it, don't just think it. I mean, you write stuff down, especially if you've been drinking. And back then, I drank a lot. It was major. I was Diamond Dallas Page. So, I mean, I wrote all this down. I go, Diamond Dallas Page, the Diamond Exchange. I go, I got the Diamond Dolls. I go, man, that's B-A-double-D bad. I looked around. I went, wow, has anybody ever said that? Has anybody ever, did I just make that up? And I wrote that down. And about 3 days later, this guy, Kevin Dunn, comes, you know, calls me up and wants to do a story on The Voice. So we set it up, and I got a 62 pink Cadillac at the time. I'll put some pictures up of that with this piece right here. We got pictures of me and the Cadillac driving, me and the stud. We're going to do stuff in the station, writing with my buddy Bobby, Bobby Scarcello. And then we're going to do stuff in the office. So when we're there, at some point he says, so where does The Voice come from? And I throw on a pair of sunglasses and I go, The Voice comes from Diamond Dallas Page, did it? I was born to be a professional wrestling manager. And I went on this rant and took the glasses off and I just kept talking. So some guy named Smitty sees this thing on his Party News Network in Fort Myers, Florida. And he calls up and he says that he wants to speak to me. So I get a little call back in my office. Hey, Page J, some guy named, some sports guy wants to talk to Diamond Dallas Page. So I pick up the phone and I go, hey, Smokey, fuck you. And I'm on the phone. And as it turns out, he calls back. He says, tell him it's not Smokey, it's Smitty, and I'm Smitty Sports Talk, and I would love to have him on the show. I pick up the phone and I go, dude. I go, I don't really do this. I go, I was just ranting. I tried wrestling when I was a kid, but you know, I'm not a manager. He goes, hey, but nobody knows that. It's radio. And I was like, oh, yeah, I guess you're right. He goes, I'm going to have Captain Lou Albano on the show. I'm like, Captain Lou? Oh, man. I'm a huge mark for Captain Lou growing up. So I'm like, I get to talk to Captain Lou? This is killer. So I go and do the show. It's great. We have a great time. I don't know if it was great, but Smitty said it was great. And then I come back again and do it with Sergeant Slaughter. And I just saw Sarge about 6 months ago at Florida Championship Wrestling. I was going to visit my mentor, Dusty Rhodes, and my good friend, Steve Kern. And actually, Sarge remembered that. He saw me in the background. He goes, what are you doing here, kid? So I just came down here to hear you, champ. And he said, you guys? And he mentioned it. He said, I did an interview with DDP 20 years ago. He was a wannabe manager. The same wannabe manager went on to be a three-time world champion. And he gave me the I salute you thing from Sergeant Slaughter. Pretty damn sweet. Because as a man who's over 6 foot, Sergeant 6'4", and in his prime, he was a good 280, 300 pounds. And he could work better than probably any guy alive around that size. He was amazing. And to get that comps from, you know, that props from Sarge was huge. So the bottom line is that I did that show. And then after that, Smitty says to me, you know, I got this friend of mine at the AWA. His name's Rob Russin. He goes, you should send him a videotape. So that next week, I got to it. And I'm just going to give you the cliff notes here. I made up the videos. I developed, I mean, all the clothes you're going to see me wearing in the second video, I wore those in a nightclub all the time. I used to say to my buddy Kurt Church, can you imagine if I ever have to have a reason to wear these kind of clothes? Well, it was about to happen. It was all about to come to fruition because I sent that videotape to the AWA and they called me 2 weeks later and they said, DDP, we want to have you come in and, you know, want to hear, you know, we want to bring you guys in for a tryout. I go, we got one problem. And they're like, what's the problem? I go, none of those guys can wrestle. It's like, what? What'd you end up sending us the tape for? I go, well, you know, I can manage. They want to wrestle. And they went, oh, don't call us. We'll call you. Right there, I'm going to leave you with that quote and kill it out of here. Because I got to get it before this 10 minutes is up. You'll hear the rest of this story next week. See ya! bang!